There will now be an opportunity for silent prayer or meditation. Thanks. Please be seated. Honorable members, I wish to acknowledge the presence in the gallery of the delegates who are attending a meeting of the newly established African Network of Parliamentary Budget Offices, hosted by our Parliamentary Budget Office. The delegates are from Kenya, Uganda, Ghana, Zambia, and Nigeria. Honorable members, you are welcome. Honorable members, I also wish to announce that I have received a letter from the Honorable S.O.R. Mahuma Pilu, Premier of the Northwest Province. The Premier has apologized for not being able to attend today's session. In the letter, the Premier states the following, among others. I quote, "On the occasion of SONA, there was an unfortunate off-the-record altercation between myself and Honorable Steenhuisen of the DA. I must say I regret for having overreacted to the honorable member concerned, and my actions were not justifiable, and I profusely and unreservedly apologize." I thank you.
Order, members. The secretary will read the order of the day.
Reply by the president to the debate on the State of the Nation address.
Thank you. The Honorable the President.
Thank you. Honorable Speaker, Honorable Chairperson of the NCOP, all presiding officers, Honorable Deputy President, Honorable Ministers, Premiers, Deputy Ministers, Chairperson of the South African Local Government Association, Honorable Members, fellow South Africans, special guests, we thank you all for the contributions to the debate on the 2017 State of the Nation Address. Let me extend again our deepest condolences to the families of psychiatric patients who died so tragically in Gauteng. This matter is deeply painful for the country and should not be used for political gains. Government will continue to support the families and to ensure that the recommendations of the health ombudsperson are implemented. Let me thank all South Africans for taking the time to listen to the SONA. In spite of the shocking and unbecoming behavior that was displayed in this house again last Thursday by some members, our people elect members every 5 years to represent them in Parliament and to fulfill the tasks outlined in the Constitution for the legislative arm of the state. The majority of members of Parliament understand the serious responsibility that they have been entrusted with and conduct themselves in a manner that gives hope to South Africans. However, some members or some MPs have decided to treat this august house like something worse than a beer hall. The conduct we saw in this house traumatized millions of South Africans, as well 12-year-old Given Lubisi, who came here to impress members of Parliament and the nation with his artistic skills. Let me extend a warm welcome to Given, who is my special guest today. We again appeal to those MPs and parties that have taken a decision to cause mayhem in the House to use available democratic mechanisms to express themselves within the bounds of decency and decorum. As adults, we can disagree ideologically, but we should not lose the track of the national interests. Respect for one another and for our parliament will restore the dignity of this important house and give hope to our people. Honorable members and compatriots, the message of SONA 2017 is clear and simple. The political freedom gained in 1994 must be accompanied by economic freedom for the black majority in this country and the Africans in particular. We are not going to be apologetic about that. It is part of the South African story, a historic fact. Radical socio-economic transformation will help us to grow the economy in an inclusive manner, ensuring true reconciliation and prosperity. We have noted with shock statements from some in the opposition benches that our radical economic transformation program will not succeed because it has not succeeded anywhere else. That is a confirmation that some of our compatriots are determined to defend and protect the status quo and ensure that the ownership, control, and management of the economy remains skewed in favor of a racial minority. We welcome the fact that most members support the program. The fact that white households earn 5 times more than black households cannot guarantee a sustainable and prosperous future for all. The ownership figures of companies at the Johannesburg Stock Exchange should worry any leader in our country who wants to see a sustainable future. The fact that there is no proliferation of successful black-owned mining companies 23 years into freedom, as stated by the Honorable Luzipho, should unite us, all of us, into finding solutions. Abantu abamnyama kufanele bangabi abasebenzi nje kuphela. Kufanele babe nezimboni, babe is a manager, babe nemifela ndawonye exhaswe uhulumeni. Kufanele babe nomhlaba, balime, badle izingane, bondle izingane zabo. Sisho lokho ngalolu hlelo lokuguqula isisekelo somnotho nenhlalo uqobo lwayo. Indeed, we agree with Honorable Godi that economic transformation must not only be radical, it should be revolutionary. Honorable Minister Quinty summarized what needs to be transformed as per our definition: the structure, systems, ownership, control, and institutions. Honorable Minister Hadebe pointed out that radical socio-economic transformation is not just political rhetoric. This is a serious program, and it will be implemented by government using the strategic levers that are available to the state. These include legislation, regulations, licensing, budget, and procurement, as well as broad-based black economic empowerment charters. It is a practical, implementable program, as outlined by Honorable MEC Zikalala, who shared what KwaZulu-Natal province is already doing and will be doing to implement the program. Bevula umnotho, bevulela abamnyama, ababeshiwe ngaphandle ezweni labo. Operation Vula Wesibili. Honorable Lucas, the Premier of the Northern Cape, also outlined plans and programs of the Northern Cape and the opportunities. Indeed, many provinces will be able to put this program into action. The role of municipalities as engines for economic growth in ensuring radical transformation is key, as outlined by Councillor Tau. The challenges of municipalities, such as the unsustainable debt owed to them, which is currently standing at 113 billion rand, needs urgent attention. That is what the Back to Basics government program is all about: assisting municipalities to deal with such challenges. We assure the Honorable Ngwabe that government values cooperatives and that many already provide services to government. His concern is indeed noted. Uhlelo lokuphekela izingane ezikoleni olondla izingane ezidlulile ezigidini ezisishiyagalolunye lusiza imifelandawonye emningi ephethwe omama emalokishini nasezindaweni zasemakhaya okuthengwa kuyo ukudla. Nomnyango kwezenhlalakahle usebenzisa le mifelandawonye emningi athenga kuyo ukudla ukudla okudliwa ngabantwana nokudliwa yilabo abadla imbuya ngothi. Cooperatives will continue to receive support from government as part of economic empowerment. Honorable Mohai, indeed, the agreement on the national minimum wage by social partners led by the Deputy President is a key milestone in tackling the problems of the working poor and income inequality. As you correctly pointed out, the national minimum wage is not the living wage, but it goes a long way in addressing the problem of the working poor. Honorable Coleman, you are correct. Indeed, we are moving beyond the formula of 5% ownerships and empowerment through dividend payments only. Our SMME and Black economic empowerment policies will also prioritize the development of entrepreneurs who pay a meaningful role, who play a meaningful role in the productive sectors of the economy beyond shareholder transactions. That is why we speak of Black industrialists, as we wanted to see factories owned by Black people in the manufacturing sector. Honorable Minister Zulu provided more information on the 30% compulsory subcontracting that I announced in the SONA. The Department of Small Business Development will work with state-owned companies and enterprises, as well as government departments, to ensure that SMMEs benefit from this new policy development. Education is an important instrument for radical socioeconomic transformation. Education was used as an instrument of subjugation, and we are using it as an instrument to free the current and the next generations from the shackles of the past. We agree that some communities still face difficulties with schools that are far from ideal in both structure and capacity to teach. Work is ongoing to change the situation around. Honorable Shenge raised concern about the pace of the replacement of MAD schools. The Accelerated Schools Infrastructure Delivery Initiative program is proceeding well, although it has been hit by difficulties in some areas. Difficulties that have caused delays include work stoppages due to disputes on site about who should be employed or not in some areas, or stoppages due to wage disputes. The project has also faced difficult terrain in our rural communities where work must stop after rains at times. We are sure, Umntwana wakwaPhindangene, that government is determined to finish this program. Honorable Masesi, government is doing a lot systematically to rebuild schools that have poor structures and to provide the mud, the much needed amenities. Over and above the mud schools that are being replaced, government has, through the ACD program, provided water to 615 schools, decent sanitation to our 125 schools, and electricity to 307 schools. Uhulumeni uyaqhuba. Uyaqhubeka nokulungisa izikole ezindaweni zonke zezwe lakithi. Uma singakafiki ngakini, ungadikibali siyeza. Ngeke siphumule zingakalungi zonke izikole, ikakhulukazi emalokishini nasezindaweni zasemakhaya. Honorable Shenge, there is no wholesale replacement of textbooks that takes place each year because the curriculum has not changed. Each year, the Department of Basic Education delivers top-up books to replace damaged, lost, or books not returned to schools. That's why it looks like there is no very massive book delivery. Honorable Shenge, Nesikalo Samans, siyezwakala. Ezindaweni eziningi koZululand, Zimkhulu, sorry, Mzimvubu, Khanyakude, nakwezinye izifundazwe, abantu basalinde amanzi. Ingakho sakha amadamu amasha, silungisa futhi namadamu akhona enziwa makhulu, ngoba sizama ukuhlinzeka abantu ngamanzi. I decided to establish a standalone Department of Water and Sanitation in 2014 because of the realization of the need to ensure improvements in extending water to our people. Given the serious drought situation that face our country government through the Department of Water and Sanitation has spent over 500 million rand on emergency and short-term interventions in KwaZulu-Natal, Free State, Northwest, Eastern Cape, Mpumalanga, Limpopo, Western Cape, and the Northern Cape. The water and sanitation program continues nationwide. Honorable Mkongi outlined the extent to which government has ensured success to education by children from primary to secondary education levels. Importantly, you reminded us that our youth is not a lost generation. They know what they want for themselves and their country, as demonstrated by the increased numbers in higher education institutions each time we start every year. They don't seem to be lost. They seem to be knowing what they want to do. That's why they flood schools. The radical education transformation program of government supports our youth through the creation of economic opportunities to ensure that they are employed and have access to entrepreneurial opportunities. Government will intensify efforts to deal with challenges facing the higher education and training sector to make higher education accessible to more students from the poor families and the families of the working class. As I mentioned in the SONA, some measures have already been undertaken. The university debt of NSFAS qualifying students for 2013, 2014, and 2015 academic years have been paid by the government. In total, government has reprioritized 32 billion rand within government baselines to support higher education. Over the coming months, government policies will respond directly to the concerns raised by the students, including consideration of raising the NSFAS thereof of 122,000 rand. Secondly, as I mentioned, the students have pointed out that the full cost of study at some universities is higher than the subsidy that NSFAS provides, and this too must be urgently addressed. Honorable members emphasized the need for economic activities to take place beyond the main centers only, and also the revitalization of rural and township economy. We will use the special economic zones and industrial parks as instruments of boosting jobs and inclusive growth, and also to de-racialize economic activities away from the usual urban centers as part of economic transformation. Compatriots, Honorable Minister Shabangu reminded us of the strides made by women in the field of science in our country thanks to the hard work of government through the Department of Science and Technology, amongst others. Let me join the minister in congratulating Minister Naledi Pandor on winning the 2016 Award for Science Diplomacy for using science and technology to support development in South Africa and Sub-Saharan Africa. As we celebrate the advancement of women, let me also take this opportunity to welcome the progress made in gender equity in the judiciary at the level of magistrates. A total of 245 magistrates were appointed between 2015 and 2016. The racial and gender breakdown of the appointments of the appointees reflects 93 African females. Mm. 64 African males. 19 colored male, 18 white female, 13 colored female, 9 Indian females, 9 Indian males, 22 Indian females, and 8 white males. This appointment of a significant number of women in the magistracy is an important milestone in the transformation of the judiciary. We congratulate the judiciary in this regard. Honorable Waters, indeed, I am happy that I visited Nyanga Police Station on Tuesday. I saw firsthand the conditions under which the police work and under which the people live. Kuyinkinga kakhulu ukuthi amaphoyisa ayazibamba izigebengu kodwa zidedelwe eyinkantolo. Ngithatha isinqumo sokuthi lolu hlelo kufanele ukuthi lubhekisiswe uma sithi silwa nobulelesi. Asikwazi ukuthi silwa nobulelesi sibe sazi ukuthi kunzima kangakanani singakulungisi lokho okufuna kulungiswa. It is not only Nyanga that is facing challenges with regards to crime. Other parts of Cape Town are also facing problems, and other townships around the country. I mentioned Soshanguve in the SONA. We will intensify the focus on promoting safety and security this year, working with our people. I will be meeting with the Justice Crime Prevention and Security Cluster soon to discuss this matter further. P- part of what the officers told me at Nyanga was that they are faced with a problem that they arrest criminals. But the problem is that when they get to court, they are released. And once they are released, they actually interfere with witnesses. And they say, if, for an example, a perpetrator kills a person and there is somebody who is there, sees everything, and the police take a statement where he gives or she gives the details, and perhaps is the only person who can give such account. Once the perpetrator is released, works out a way to kill that person. And once that happens, the case is over. And I'm sure when we meet with the Klasa, we'll discuss this. What does this mean? Are the weaknesses within our laws or the constitution? And I asked the officials, what is the problem? They said, well, we have to respect the right of an individual. I must say, it's a problem to me. If the perpetrator don't just undermine the right of an individual, but undermine it in the manner that makes the individual who is a victim lose the life. So the right to live is undermined by a criminal. But the criminal has a right not to go to jail, because we must respect the right of the criminal. There is something wrong that needs to be looked at, and I'm sure this honorable house is a matter you should concern yourself. How do we make the crime disappear? You cannot allow a situation where justice and commission of crime live side by side forever. We need to find a way to handle the matter. Honorable Malansi, Honorable Julius, and others stated that the ANC has failed to address land restitution. I stated upfront in the SONA that we have not met the targets. One reason for the delays is that we had chosen to use the willing buyer, willing seller principle, which in many cases resulted in the state having to pay large sums of money to acquire land. The introduction of the Office of the Valuer General is assisting us to ensure that we do not pay excess land prices. The Land Expropriation Amendment Act, when finalized, will also assist in fast-tracking land reform. This government has the interest of the people at large and people at heart. And will do all in its power to ensure that land is returned to the people. Umhlaba uzobuyela kubantu. Kuyamangaza ukubona amaqembu asekhuluma sengathi amiganya nabantu odabeni lomhlaba sibe sazi kahle ukuthi emlandweni kanye namanje ami kanye nalabo abaqola umhlaba Honorable Semenya outlined the progress made in land and agrarian reform, and indeed much more still needs to be done to support agriculture. She raised important issues, including funding, which needs to be attended to. Honorable Masango raised a concern about the social grants payments matter. The Department of Social Development and the National Treasury are seized with this matter. Radical economic transformation must be supported by advanced information and communications technology sector, as Honorable Minister Kwele outlined. The broadband rollout and the lowering of the cost of data remain apex priority. This is a concern of many honorable members. Honorable Olomisa, we wish you well with the National Consultative Conference that your party will finally organize this year, which you have been talking about for a while. Honorable Groeneveld, affirmative action and black economic empowerment do not demonstrate hatred to white people. They are aimed at ensuring the achievement of true reconciliation in the country based on the Constitution of the Republic. The Constitution joins us to heal the divisions of the past and to establish a society based on democratic values, social justice, and fundamental human rights. Radical economic transformation, of which affirmative action and BEE form a part of healing the divisions of the past. White compatriots will be part of this process, as it will assist us to achieve a truly united, non-racial, and prosperous South Africa. I think, honorable member, it would be wise to disabuse yourself from the tendency that when we talk about land and we talk about those who own land, you think it is because of hatred. It's not true. We are just stating a fact that massive stretches of land are owned by few, and they form part of the economic base, the land. We need to correct this, because if we don't correct it, You know, the areas that used to be called reserved, where Africans in particular were pushed to, the population has been growing and the land is not growing. And it's a problem. It's a problem that we needed to tackle. If we don't, I think we'll be not working for our future that is peaceful, because we would be saying there are people who must live without any land when there is a land in the country. And we have said we are not going to act like in other parts of the world. We have the constitution, we have the law. It is going to be between or within the parameters of the law that we are going to address this matter. It does not display hatred. It's not. We are saying this problem must be resolved. We cannot resolve it. Because if we don't, it could explode one day. The responsible leadership today must find a way to avoid that situation. So I don't think it helps to jump into phrases that if somebody talks about the land hunger, then is hating the whites. And how else could you describe those who own the land? How do you describe them if you don't say what happened? We are not even talking about the history, what happened. Many of those people did not buy the land. And we don't want to talk about that. We now know that as settlers arrived, there were people who were distributing land. And there are specific histories we know. We don't want to talk about that. That's why we just talk about correcting the past. Because we can give details what happened. Many people died. That's not the point we want to talk about. If we were driven by hatred, we would be saying, this is what happened. We are not just saying, let us find a way, a formula to solve this problem. That's all. There is no hatred. Some of us have been taught by our organization not to be racist, to know that we all belong here, but we all need enough space to live together, to be able to feel that we are indeed citizens. So I just want you to disabuse you from always when you come here, you say this is racialism. It's not. It's not. I just thought it's important to stress this point because I think it's a careless discussion. I'm just saying, please disabuse yourself from, instead of debating the issue so that we find a common agreed solutions, you point at the color. We are avoiding to point at the color. But we are describing the situation, as it were, with an aim that we should find a solution for the country. That is what we are doing. And we are not going to stop by saying you hate the whites. No, it was not true. It's not true. I've worked with the whites. There were whites who were in the struggle, were in the trenches together. I've not been with them there if I was racist. They were my comrades. We lived together. We in the ANC have gone beyond the feelings of racism, far beyond it, even before 1994. That's not the issue. Honorable members, we remain committed to the energy mix to ensure energy security in our country. Members will recall that Cabinet designated Eskom and the South African Nuclear Energy Corporation as the procurers and operators of the various components of the nuclear new build program. Let me reiterate that before any nuclear new build procurement takes place, the request for proposals have to be issued. Once proposals have been received and evaluated, the Department of Energy is required to report back to Cabinet on the proposal funding model. As I have previously indicated, any procurement process must be on a scale and at a pace that our country can afford. It is from this basis that we would be, then we would have to proceed. Compatriots, yesterday,
Ukolo Tata, Ukolo Baba, Ukolo President. Again, Kulume no Baba. Tata sicela uxolo. Awumphazamisi umongameli ethetha. Siyabulela tata pathu ungaphindi uyenze umongameli ethetha. Enkosi, President Kuba.
Compatriots.
Madam Speaker.
Yesterday.
Excuse me, President.
Madam
what
Speaker,
is the point you are rising on, Mr. Stiernaser?
14UB.
And what is the issue?
The point of the order is that members of the gallery are not supposed to participate in events.
Thank you, Honorable Stiernaser, and I agree with you. That's why I was trying to intervene.
The President has enough mbongis in the House. He doesn't need any in the gallery either.
Honorable President, please proceed.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Compatriots, yesterday, the Competition Commission announced that it has concluded an investigation into price fixing and market allocation in the trading of foreign currency involving the rand, covering the period from 2007 and found that some banks have a case to answer. This matter is still under investigation. As stated in the SONA, government is prepared to act against market abuse, price fixing, and collusion in the private sector in order to protect our country's economy. The Competition Commission can impose fines on companies, but the impact is far-reaching as it distorts our economic system. We also look forward to working with the financial sector towards diversification and transformation of the sector so that new players can enter the market as part of radical economic transformation. Minister Gwele provided an update with regards to the finalization of the Post Bank to make it a fully fledged bank. We remain committed to the establishment of a state bank. Honorable Van Dam, as Honorable Manamela pointed out, uhlulekile ukubulala isona. Angazi ukuthi wayevuke nini ngoba wabulawa nge New Year's Day. Uyacaca ukuthi enyinda. Honorable Minister Davis highlighted the changing circumstances in the global economic order, with many countries becoming inward looking, which has made South Africa to also underscore its own national interests. Many of the international developments, such as India's focus on local procurement, the United Kingdom's newfound interest in industrial strategy, and the United States' drive to to bring back the manufacturing to its shores are, in fact, priorities that government identified in the National Development Plan and is actively implementing. In pursuit of the national interests, we remind the private sector to cooperate with government on promotion or promoting local content of the designated products of our country. These include rail, rolling stock, set-top boxes, solar water heaters, transformers, furniture products, and rail signaling systems, to mention a few. We also appeal to South Africans as well to buy local products so that we can create and save jobs. Compatriots, Oliver Tambo, personified unity and love for South Africa and its people. In his memory, we should all work hard to promote unity and not allow petty political differences to divide our nation. We also need to meet our international obligations with respect to the treatment of refugees and nationals of other countries on our soil, while ensuring that all legal processes are followed for their stay in our country. In the 2016 SONA, I reported that I had visited the Home Affairs Office in Marabastad, in Tswane, and had received complaints from foreign and African nationals about, among others, long queues, criminal syndicates, overcrowding, poor administrative facilities, and other difficulties at the refugee reception center. Tomorrow, on the 17th February, we will be launching the new center, which has been refurbished by the Department of Home Affairs. I'm happy to announce, honorable members, that it shall be named after a distinguished South African with an exemplary track record in the promotion of justice, human rights, freedom, and equality, Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu. Compatriots, this year marks the 40th anniversary of the murder of Mr. Stephen Biko by the apartheid state. We will mark the Human Rights Day commemoration at Ginsberg in King Williamstown in the Eastern Cape on March 21st in his honor. He paid the supreme price for freedom. Honorable Minister Mapisa Ngagula stated that the South African National Defense Force is an instrument for peace which creates fertile ground for the stimulation of vibrant economic activity. We will celebrate our Defense Force at the annual Armed Forces Day parade on the 21st of February at Moses Mabhida Stadium in Durban. Last year, the celebration was held in Port Elizabeth. This year's Armed Forces Day has special meaning as it marks the commemoration of the centenary of the tragic sinking of the ship, the Mendi, carrying more than 600 black South Africans participating in the First World War. A number of built-up activities are already taking place in Durban, to which members of the public are invited. South Africa will host the Global Entrepreneurship Network Congress as gathering of startup champions for the first time in Sandton next month. We look forward to hosting global SMMEs on our shores. We are also very proud to host yet again the World Economic Forum Africa meeting, bringing together global political and business leaders. It will take place in Durban on the 3rd to the 5th May. Compatriots, we have it within our power to complete the transformation of our country. We'll pursue radical socio-economic freedom with vigor so that we can achieve prosperity, unity, and true reconciliation in our country. We shall do this in memory of Oliver Reginald Tambo and all who sacrificed lives, all who sacrificed lives, comforts for a free, just, and equal society in our country. I thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.
I thank the Honorable the President. That concludes the debate on the State of the Nation Address and business for the day. The joint sitting is adjourned.